Hello everybody, welcome to my presentation about the state and the future of generic Cixlopan. My name is Alexander Ahring. I'm also one of the maintainer of the Cixlopan branch and IEEE 802.15.4 maintainer. So let's start. So Cixlopan, it's a standard by IETF. And it stands for IPv6 over low power wireless personal area networks. And you know IPv6, but what the hell is a low pan? So a low pan has several properties. It's a wireless communication and has low range and low weight and also low power. You can also add a property low cost, because these transceivers are really cheap, mostly. And examples for such a low pan layer is 802.15.4 or Bluetooth Low Energy. There are also drafts about running a 6LowPAN over NFC, near field communication, and also ultra low energy DECT. And low power Wi-Fi and power line. So 6LowPAN adaptation. You have here a simple layer graphic. You have your IPv6 packet layer, and after that, then you have no Ethernet layer. You have an adaption layer, which is the 6LowPAN layer. And after the 6LowPAN layer, you have your link layer, which can be Bluetooth Low Energy, 802.15.4, or NFC. So what is 6LowPAN? 6LowPAN is more a header family. IANA describes a dispatch value. This dispatch value need to be registered at IANA. So if you want to have a new 6LowPAN header, you need to IANA need to register them by the dispatch value, and it defines very different header types, like for IPv6 and next header compression. Here's IP header compression and next header compression, and also fragmentation if the link layer doesn't reach the IPv6 minimum MTU, and also addressing header. And also our raw IPv6 header that's sometimes necessary for fragmentation. Then you don't compress the header. So what does 6LowPAN do? On the transmit side, we get a IPv6 header from the IPv6 layer. And then the 6LowPAN adaptation layer runs a compression over the IPv6 layer to reduce the payload, and also a fragmentation if necessary. And then you have a 6LowPAN header, and the LowPAN transmitted over the air. On the receive side, we have a reassembly if it was fragmented, and also a disk compression, and we get a IPv6 header again, and then we feed the IPv6 layer with that. So, 6LowPAN adaptation. 6LowPAN headers are defined originally for 802.15.4, the simple named link LowPAN. And but the good news is newly introduced 6LowPAN adaptation, for example, running 6LowPAN over Bluetooth Low Energy, use the headers which are also used by 802.15.4. So for example, the RFC 7668, there stands the IPv6 compression format specified in RFC 6282 must be used. And this RFC describes the compression format for 802.15.4 6LowPAN. So if we combine them all together, you can imagine such graphic. Here we have a Bluetooth Low Energy 6LowPAN on this side and 802.15.4 6LowPAN on the other side. and they have some headers which are shared. For example, the fragmentation is not shared because it's already provided by Bluetooth Low Energy to have a MTU which allows to run IPv6 on it. And for example, the HC1, it's a compression format, it's already deprecated. It will never be inside this shared area. And there are also maybe the mesh addressing is not adapted yet for Bluetooth Low Energy yet, but it can be that this also moved to the shared area. If we can also imagine if we have NFC 6 low-pan additional, then the fragmentation handling headers are also moved to the shared area. So let's talk about Linux and 6 low-pan. So important note is there are two approaches to provide 6 low-pan under Linux. First is an external routing device, and the second is the full Linux way. The external routing device, there, when you type 6LowPan on the Linux in your favorite search engine, then you get some tutorials about running a TUN interface, and over IPv6 you can transmit, over SLIP you can transmit IPv6 packets, and the external routing device feeds their IPv6 stack, and then it does the 6LowPan adaptation and transmit finally over your LowPan. But this is not what we don't what we do. We do this: we move the 6LowPan stack and the LowPan link layer into the Linux kernel, and it's also transparent from user space. You have still the RFF address family from IPv6, and we access the transceiver rawly over SPI, USB, or whatever. And the current kernel situation is that we have 6LowPan support for I-802.15.4 and Bluetooth Low Energy. But also possible, maybe, is to have support for NFC, because we have a subsystem inside the kernel space which use NFC. And directories are generic 6LowPan, that's the net 6LowPan directory, and the link layer specific 6LowPan implementation is, for example, net IEEE 802.15.4 6LowPan or net Bluetooth 6LowPan. So let's talk about generic 6LowPan. The goal of this branch is to provide a 6LowPan framework. That means you have your link layer that can be whatever you imagine, like infrared or MAC 802.11, but maybe it's also not very specified by IETF, but you can simply adapt it to 6LowPan by the generic 6LowPan framework. You have always some link layer specific 6LowPan implementation with subscribe to the packet layer, and also transmit your frames, and maybe also special frame handling to pass the MAC address and such things. But you always get to some point where you want to have that the generic 6LowPan pass the header, means uncompress and run fragmentation over that and such things. It also handles the interface registration. We have in the user space one 6LowPan interface which used this type. It's a virtual interface, and on this interface you have only the raw IPv6 view. That means you don't see the 6LowPan layer anymore, and also the low-pan layer is not available anymore. And it provides the minimum MTU of 1280 bytes which is a minimum NPU for running IPv6. And we try to make one user space API so that you don't need to specialize a new user space API for different 6 low-pan link layers. For example, the 802.15.4 is here we have the 802.15.4 MAC layer. This can be also Bluetooth Low Energy or NFC or whatever you want. And then you have we have at 802.15.4 an 802.15.4 interface which has an MPU of 127 bytes. That's you can't run IPv6 normally over that. And then you have 802.15.4 6 low-pan specific implementation, which filters only on data frames. Data frames contains 6 low-pan headers and also pass the 802.15.4 address. Then we have the generic 6 low-pan layer, which handles all the fragmentation, IPHC, the header compression, and the next header compression, and builds finally the IPv6 packets and feed the IPv6 for each link layer type. And also abstract one user space API, what we try, and one interface type from user space to have a global 6 low-pan view. Doesn't matter if what a link layer you have on the bottom. So now we come to this. You remember this? That's the layer graphic where the 6 low-pan layer sits. And the question is 6 low-pan an adaptation layer only? That means, does the IPv6 stack needs a special 6 low-pan handling? And the most parts, like the fragmentation and the compression, can be done by adaptation, but there exist the RFC 6775 neighbor discovery optimization for 6 low-pan. So the neighbor discovery also store always the link layer address, and the link layer address is for each 6 low-pan adaptation different. For example, in 802.15.4, it's much complicated because 802.15.4 has two different MAC address types with different lengths. And it's also still a big to-do because the neighbor discovery can only deal with one address, which is given by the interface. And you can change during runtime. Here's an example about this. So don't be scared, because it works completely different. The RFC describes new different roles. Here we have a node role and a router and a border router. A border router always is a gateway between the IPv6 world and the 6 low-pan world. And you see here a neighbor solution. I grabbed this example because it's very it shows all the nodes type node roles here, and I need also I'm not an expert for this currently, but you see here for the neighbor solution is that you have here new option fields that isn't specified by the original neighbor discovery. But why they change it is because it's they want to be low power, and the original neighbor discovery use a lot of multicast address, and this is broadcast arrays on the link layer for wireless, and this is a low power killer, and this stuff reduce the multicast using. And we have also new message types. And yes, two worlds now coming to clash together, the Ethernet IPv6 world and the 6LoWPAN world. And yes, don't worry, we are for a friendly coexistence inside the IPv6 stack, because the Ethernet people want performance and a lot of other stuff. We want at first that we support it, and we also need we need to talk with the maintainers. Is IPv6 expert maintainer here in this room? No. I need to find him. And then we need some plan and make some different, how we can make a coexistence in the IPv6 stack. Because we currently doesn't support nothing from that. And then we can make some question, kernel space versus user space, and if the kernel space knows the roles, which I mentioned here, if the kernel space should know them. And one slide about 6LoWPAN and routing. I'm also not an expert into that, but there exists at the IETF the role group. That means role stands for routing over low power and lossy networks. Low power and lossy networks are 6LoWPAN networks. And there exists one candidate, RPL, it's pronounced Ripple. And yes, it's an open standard by IETF. It's also root over, that means it's ICMP v6 based. And there exists also an open source implementation for the user space, Onstrong. Here's the URL. And also, this is a big to do at the moment, because I didn't test it right now. So here are the mailing lists. We currently make the complete 6LoWPAN stuff on the Linux WPAN mailing list. That's the mailing list for 802.15.4 development. We name it WPAN because 802.15.4 is a very long name. And also Linux Bluetooth. Maybe we want a third mailing list for Linux 6LoWPAN than for the generic stuff. So are there any questions? Yes?
Do you have any idea about why is the mesh stuff only on the 802.15.4 and not on the BTLE?
Yes, Bluetooth, the question was, why is the mesh stuff only on the 802.15.4 standard? Bluetooth is only a point-to-point communication, and that's currently in the current standard 4.2 still there, but they want to change it. They want to be more meshing into the standard, but why it's only on 802.15.4? 802.15.4 was made for Internet of Things and also to run 6LoWPAN over that, and to have more meshing. It's more like Ethernet and wireless communication, not always point to point. You don't want to see the Bluetooth low energy 6LoWPAN specific stuff, because if you run multicast on it, then they have some master slave algorithm that the master share all the packets to the slaves, and it's not very, very easy. But they want to change it in the Bluetooth Low Energy standard. Another question? I have also some hardware here. So if you want to see some 802.15.4 6LoWPAN example, also with some microcontroller OS. So I can show you if you want. I'm all days here, and then you simply ask me, and then I can give some Wireshark examples. Question? Okay.
Could you